No, no, always the zodiac is divided into 27 equal parts. It is altogether a different division. No, no, this is the number of years for each planetary period. Always they occur in the same succession in the three arcs. Taurus is there, but the division is different. Taurus is there, suppose this is Aries. In Aries, you will have 13 degrees and 20 minutes as the first division. So, you have the second division also in Aries, up to 26 degrees and odd. So, the third division will be a little in Aries and much in Taurus. So, this is altogether a different division of the same zodiac. Yes, normal
zodiac. Yeah, yeah,
no,
yeah.
Not the reverse. Not the reversed wheel. Because yes.
Yeah.
Okay. We divide into 27 signs, and each sign is 13 degrees 20.
Okay.
Tomorrow I will give you the names of the signs also, because today it will be confusing. I have not given it, because we should be adjusted to the new division. Then tomorrow I will give you the names. Now again, so we will go to Aquarius. It is described here that the fourth stage of establishment. Yesterday we have seen four stages of consciousness. Our consciousness will be established in the fourth stage with the help of the sign Taurus. So, Taurus governs the consciousness of the fourth stage. Yesterday, there was no doubt about it. You could understand it, the four stages of consciousness. And also, Aquarius belongs to the fourth stage of consciousness. Now we are explaining something more about the fourth stage. The fourth stage of establishment is the location of man, para state of walk. Here the words are Sanskrit. I will explain them. The word walk means word. Word, voice. In Sanskrit it is walk. In English we call it word and voice. So, while we are speaking also, we have four stages of our speech. Because we have four stages of consciousness in us, when we speak, each word passes through the four stages of consciousness. I will explain you how we have the word passing through the four stages. Suppose I say, this is a glass. This is a glass is a sentence. What is that sentence? It is vocal sentence. Vocal sentence.
Yes.
And also English sentence. So when we say this is a glass, it is vocal English sentence. No doubt. Similarly, in every language we have vocal language sentence. For example, vocal German sentence. Vocal French sentence. Everyone will have his own vocal language sentence. Take it as the first sentence. Vocal language sentence. Vocal language sentence. Vocal means that is coming through your voice. Language means your own language. Before you speak this sentence out, you should have the whole sentence in your mind. Accept it? Unless you don't have the whole sentence in the mind, you cannot speak out the sentence vocally. So, before the vocal language sentence, you have another sentence in your mind. Vocal mental sentence. Okay? Mental language sentence.
Mental
language sentence.
Mental.
Yes.
And then and then the vocal sentence is coming. So now we have two sentences. But before you have the mental language sentence, you have another sentence. It is mental sentence but not language. It comes to your mind as a sentence of idea, and then you will translate it into your own language in mind, and then you will speak it out. So we have three sentences. So the third is mental, no language but sentence. So no language. Everyone gets the same sentence into the mind, and then he translates it into his language, and then he speaks it out. So we have three sentences, and then you have the fourth sentence. Before the third sentence comes to your mind, now you should be able to understand how the fourth sentence will be, because if you count from the other side, it should be the first sentence to take birth in you. And then this becomes the second sentence, and then this becomes the third sentence, and your vocal sentence becomes the fourth. Okay? We should know how this first sentence will be. The first three, it is very easy to know, but the fourth, a little bit difficult. We will know it. Understand that there is a wave in the ocean. Before the wave started, where was it? How was it? No. Was it the wave or what? Was it the ocean? Yes. So, how could the wave differentiate from the ocean? Now we can understand that it was only one with the ocean. There were no two things like the wave and the ocean at first. But the second thing came out from the first thing. It is something like one becoming two. So it was only one ocean before the wave started. After the wave started, it is the ocean and the wave. That is two items. Understand? Similarly, here you have your world and yourself. Before the world started from you, it was only yourself. There was no world. But from you, the world started. And it became different from you. This is called the birth of objectivity. This is what happens when we awake from sleep. See, while we are sleeping, we are not two with the whole of the creation. We are only one. But when we awake, we are the second from all the other rest of the world. Our mind becomes two.
Why?
And sees itself separate from the world and looks the world separate from itself. It is called the birth of objectivity. Here also, when you begin to speak, that is when the second word comes out from you, it exists different from you in you. That means it begins to exist objectively in you. But before that, it existed with you. It was only yourself. And then it began to exist with you. And it began to separate from you. And it came out from you as separate world. So these four states in you are existing because these four states exist in the creation itself. You see, first the creation was with the creator. It was not different from him. Then it comes out as a wave from him. And then it comes into the third stage, the mental creation, which we call the mental plane of this creation. And then the fourth stage of creation is what we see as the outer world. having the name, the shape, and the nature of things. So we have these four stages in creation itself. We are part of the creation. Therefore, our mind also has these four stages. So yesterday we have seen our mind has these four stages, and whenever we want to speak a sentence or a word, it passes the first three stages, comes to the fourth stage before we speak out. Is it clear? Yes, it automatically takes place. Whatever you speak, unless these four stages take place, the sentence does not come out into your mind and it cannot pass through you. See how the automatic electronic machine works. If you feed some information and programming in the machine, whenever you use it, it undergoes all the informations you have given to it. Even though you use it for fun, or if you use it for a serious purpose, in the machine all the stages automatically take place. No doubt about it. And this gives us a formula to go into meditation. When you are speaking a sentence, you are coming out in four steps as your word. If you can go inside into these four steps, the fourth step is called Samadhi in yoga. And you know a sentence, a mantra in the gospel, which is rightly translated into English also. First there was the word. The word was with God. The word was God. Now you can understand the meaning of that sentence. The fourth stage is the whole world. It existed as the word or the utterance of the Creator. The word was with God. That was in the previous stage. And in the last stage, the word was God. Yes, only in the third stage, your word comes into your language. So the third and the fourth stage belong to our language. The first and second are common to everyone.
Okay.
So between the second and the third stages, we will have the story of the Tower of Babel and the curse. That story is an allegory that takes place between two and three stages. During the first two stages, all are having the same language, that is divine language. But on the third stage and fourth stage, everyone is having his own language and one cannot understand the other. This is called the curse of Babel. That means the limitation, mental limitation. Now, here, this stage is represented by Aquarius. That is the Samadhi state of consciousness which you will experience by practicing yoga. That experience will be given by the Aquarius to everyone. That state of consciousness experience will be given to everyone by the influence of Aquarius. Because the sign Aquarius has the properties of Samadhi. So in every one of us, whether our ascendant is Aquarius or not, the sign governs the highest state of consciousness. In that state, we will be in God's state. It is called the highest state. In Sanskrit, it is called Para, or the highest. Para means the highest. So, the fourth stage of establishment is the location of man, the Para state of work. That is, in the highest stage of his own utterance. That is the meaning. Now, we will see how the highest utterance will be. No, with the telepathy, the third state of language is necessary.
The second
is necessary. The first is utterer himself. The second is thought language, thought without language. So telepathy takes place on the second stage. During sleep, a sentence or a lesson is transmitted without a language, and when you wake up in the morning, you can receive it only in language. You see, when it is the beginning stage of telepathy between a disciple and his master, the master gives one thought to the disciple without any language at all. When the disciple is sleeping, because unless he is in sleep, the mind cannot be without his own thoughts. You see, as long as you are having your own thoughts, you will be having your language with your thoughts, because normally no one can think thoughts without their language. Whether you speak or not, if you think a thought in your mind, you will think in German. I will think in my own language. The English fellow thinks in his own language. So you can never think a thought directly, because from your childhood you are habituated to think in your language. You cannot filter the language and keep the thought. It requires great yogic discipline. So what your master does in the beginning is, he has to catch hold of your mind without thoughts, but he can never find you without thoughts. As long as you are awake, you are having your own thoughts and you are having your own language. So the master has no possibility to catch your neck. So he waits until you sleep. But in sleep, the trouble is you have no mind. You cannot receive, but the master can make you receive by a peculiar process of sending his thought to your second stage of world. He will give his thought to your mind. At that time, he can disturb you, but not completely. Only one layer of consciousness will be disturbed. Then only it is called telepathy. Then he will give his thought to you. In the morning, you will get the thought in your own language. And then sometimes you think that it is your own thought, but the thought is given as a seed. In course of weeks and months, that one thought repeats in your mind and begins to germinate into a subject. Care to take down the notes daily in a separate book, then the subject will be received with your mind in the form of beautiful lessons and paragraphs. And after one subject is received by you, then the master will send you a second thought. That means after 5 months or 6 months or 10 months. This is how they do in the beginning. After some years, you will be able to receive the whole lesson the next day morning in your own language. And then the master can give the next lesson the next night. Then after 10 or 15 years of practice, you will be able to keep your mind away from your language. Then the master can contact with your mind when you are awake. Then he begins to transmit lessons to you directly when you are awake. At first, you will be making many mistakes in receiving the lesson, because you have to translate into your language. But gradually, you will get a beautiful tuning with the mind of the master, and the whole process becomes automatic. Just as the typist will be typing the material without looking at the keyboard, you will be directly receiving and writing lessons from the master. This is how Alice A. Bailey received from the Tibetan. This is what is called the work of telepathy. But you should remember one thing. Telepathy has nothing to do with spirit mediumship. Yes. Spiritism is quite different. Spiritism means receiving into the mind messages from recently dead people. that is very bad. You will get all sorts of nonsense in the name of messages.
Unsinn in Ihrem Denken.
So, if the dead man is a bluffer or a deceit or a cheat, then he will deceive you
Betrügen.
By misguiding you. Suppose you ask, who are you? He may tell you, I am the great poet Goethe, or Shakespeare, or Master Moria. So the fool says that he is Moria. Then if you ask, I am having stomachache, can you tell me some medicine? That fool dictates to you, eat cheese. You should never believe that he is Master Moria. The masters never contact like that. So you should be careful in differentiating the two phenomena. The one is very pure and very sacred. The second is very impure and very unhealthy. Gradually the mind becomes unhealthy and the mind loses its morality. It begins to bluff its own thoughts in the name of the master. There are people who take the pen in their hands and they write pages and pages about their own ideas, and they say that it is dictated by some unknown spirit. This is the loss of morality because of the contact of dead astral matter. The dead matter is very decayed and foul, influences the mind in a bad way,